Good morning. Like we completed limits long back, lot of journey we did with the limits. Now we are doing the next chapter called differentiation. I think I started differentiation. Yeah, I started differentiation and we are doing started differentiation and we did the first, what it's called, first principle of derivative questions we did. Stay like that. Yeah, now we'll do some of the differentiation part. So before going to start the differentiation, first write some formulas on the differentiation. Okay, and after that we can do the things. Before the guys are adding, first to copy the differentiation formulas. First one, d by dx of constant is equal to zero. Second one, d by dx of x power n is n into x power n minus 1. Here, with respect to this, we'll write the examples also. Okay. D by dx of 6 is equal to 0. Yes. D by dx of x power 6 is equal to 6 into x power 5. Third one, d by dx of e power x equal to e power x. Everyone note down. Log x is equal to 1 by x. D by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x, d by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x. D by dx of sine x is equal to cos x. D by dx of cos x is equal to minus sine x. D by dx of tan x is equal to secant square x. D by dx of secant x is equal to secant x tan x. D by dx of cot x equal to minus cosecant square x. D by dx of cosecant x equal to minus cosecant x cot x. Please copy this. completed, write it fastly. All the formulas I'll give today. But since we are at the starting level, small formulas, basic questions, formulas only we'll do. Once we are habituated to this differentiation, then we'll go to the large, big formula.
So what is the sixth number, sir?
Sixth, d by dx of sine x. Trigonometry sine cos we'll study. Make it fast, don't waste time copying. Completed. Don't write the mistake.
Completed, sir.
Very good. The next one. Completed, everyone, please. But because when I am solving the question, you should need these all things, or else it will become wrong. Now, so question number 12. D by dx of, we'll write hyperbolic functions now. The hyperbolic functions is d by dx of sine hx d equal to is equal to cos hx. D by dx of cos hx is equal to sin x hx, there minus you will not get there. D by dx of tan hx is equal to secant square hx. D by dx of secant hx is equal to secant hx into tan hx. D by dx of cot hx is equal to minus cosecant square hx. It's a minus we'll get here. Minus.
D by dx cos hx equal to minus sine hx.
No. साधा साइन है हाइपरबोलिक में नेगेटिव नहीं आया भाई ये साइन में कॉस में सीकेंट में कॉट में कोसेकेंट में नेगेटिव आया इट इज इक्वल टू माइनस कोसेकेंट एच एक्स इनटू कॉट एच एक्स डोंट मगअप ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड फर्स्ट नॉर्मल सी बिफोर वी स्टडीड नॉर्मल ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिकल रेशियोस sine, cos, tan and all. Now we are studying hyperbolic functions. Both difference, दोनों को difference क्या ना? ये में cos का sin negative sin आया, ये तो cos में positive sin आया. If it's completed, please let me know.
Sir?
Yeah.
Sir, आप जो फाइव नंबर पर लिखा था d by dx into root x, उसका 1/2 root x कैसे हुआ? 2 root x
है.
ये सर कैसे बता सकते?
कैसे आया? means you want proof na?
Yes sir.
Yeah. D by dx is equal to root x equal to 1 by 2 root x a by root I. What is the first principle we studied in the last class? F dash of x is equal to limit h tends to 0. F of x plus h minus f of x by h. A first principle ka formula hai. So there in the last class.
Yes, sir.
फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल का फॉर्मूला है इसमें एफ ऑफ एक्स क्या है ना ओके एफ ऑफ एक्स इज इक्वल टू रूट एक्स दैट इज लिमिट एच टेंस टू जीरो रूट एक्स प्लस एच माइनस रूट एक्स बाय एच एंड आई एक्सप्लेन्ड लिमिट्स नो इन द लास्ट क्लासेस हाउ वी डिड द लिमिट्स फॉर दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रॉब्लम हाउ यू विल डू द लिमिट You can calculate limit by rationalizing root x plus h plus root x by root x plus h plus root x. That is limit h tends to zero a minus b into a plus b. What is this formula? Limit h tends to zero. A plus B into X plus H minus H by H into root X plus H plus root X. HH get cancelled. Limit H tends to 0, 1 by root over X plus H plus root X. Now put X is equal to 0 by. When I put X is equal to 0, what you will get? H equal to 0. 1 by root X plus root X. Matlab 1 by 2 root X. See, what are the formula I am writing on the board? Every formula have a proof. Dekho, what are the things we are writing on the board? Everything we have a proof. Understood?
How sir, we please explain proof? That again.
See, d by dx of root x is equal to 1 by 2 root x is the question. Formula and they are asking me to prove. Whenever you are proving the derivative formula, we should use the first principle. F dash of x equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x by h. So f of x kya hai? One root x. F of x plus h means root over x plus h. So root x plus h minus root x by h. Now I rationalized. Why? Because 0 by 0 formula RIA. H ka 0 substitute karo. So we are multiplying with x, root over x plus h plus x by root over x plus h plus x. So numerator, it is looking like a minus b into a plus b. It is a square minus b square. Where I simplified. And denominator is like as it is only. What is x tends to in fact? H tends to 0. Na? I have substituted h equal to 0. Root x, it will become 1 by 2 root x.
So it means that if into x plus h is equal to root over x plus h.
That's only. Na. Dekho baba. F of x is equal to root x. F of 2 kya hai? Root 2 bola na. Matlab x ka 2. F of x plus
yes,
h kya hai? Under square root of x plus h aya.
Yes, sir.
Understood?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. If you want, I'll teach one more. See, I'll teach F of x is equal to, no, I want to teach d by dx of sin x is equal to cos x proof. I'll do. See. D by dx of solution. Let f of x is equal to f of x is equal to sin x using फर्स्ट प्रिंसिपल f dash of h is equal to limit h tends to zero f of x plus h minus f of x by h f of x by h that is equal to limit h tends to zero f of x sin x na f of x plus h means sin x plus h minus this is sin x by h that is equal to limit h tends to zero it is looking like sin c minus sin d sin c minus sin d 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2 so that can be written as a 2 cos c plus 2 dono ka addition into sin dono ka subtraction x by 2 h h h by 2 now either a h a In the limits we studied, whenever in the limits you remembered, limit x tends to zero, sine x by x value is one. So recently we completed the limit like that. Yeah, by two, two do it. Now this become one, and two two getting cancelled. H ka zero substitute karo. Cos two x by two. Ye dono chalta cos x. In the second year, we have a one chapter. This only proof. How to prove trigonometry using. Now this is hyperbolic functions. Now the last one is inverse functions. D by dx of sine inverse x. D by dx of cos inverse of x. D by dx of tan inverse of x. Cot inverse of x. Secant inverse of x, cosecant inverse of x. I'll say in a shortcut. Scene. It's formula 1 by root or 1 minus x square. And here this formula minus 1 by root or 1 minus x square. The difference between them is 1 minus. 1 by x square plus a square. How important this formula, you know? Every time I'll ask that only. And this is minus 1 by x square plus a square. Minus 1 by x square plus a square. 1 by mod x into root over x square minus 1. 1 by mod x into root over x square minus 1 with a minus. Okay. See, among these, no need to study everything. I want these two. Those two only we'll ask. Copy. Now one by one, I'll ask the formulas everyone. Because your formula don't move from the meeting. If you don't know, say master, I don't know.
Sir, the tan inverse is 1 by x square plus a square.
X square plus a square.
Completed, sir.
Yeah, very good, Baba. Very good. Okay. Now the next question. Next one. Write this root x formula. completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Very good. This also. Sin x also. Only two. After this, we'll start the problems.
So once more, you may explain
this one. You want this one?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
I'll explain it. I'll erase the board again. I'll do it. To prove d by dx is equal to sin x is equal to cos x. Solution. Suppose f of x is equal to sin x. Suppose f of x is equal to sin x. Using first principle, f dash of x is equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x plus h minus f of x by h. That is equal to limit h tends to 0, f of x is sin x, f of x plus h is sin x plus h, sin x by h. Now it is looking like sin c minus sin d. Sin c minus sin d, what is its formula? Sin c minus sin d, the formula we studied in the trigonometry, its formula is sin c minus sin d is equal to 2 cos c plus d by 2 into sin c minus d by 2. That is limit h tends to 0, 2 cos दोनों का एडिशन बाय टू इनटू साइन दोनों का सब्ट्रैक्शन बाय टू बाय हेच दैट इज इक्वल टू लिमिट एच टेंस टू जीरो टू कॉस टू एक्स प्लस हेच बाय टू इनटू साइन हेच बाय टू बाय हेच इज देयर सो वी नो द फॉर्मूला लिमिट एच टेंस टू जीरो साइन एक्स बाय एक्स इज वन. Yo, how many questions you have did? Limit x tends to 0, sin x by x is equal to 1. This is the thing. The sin h by 2, na? You divided with 2, multiply with 2. Then this become 1. This 2 is getting cancelled. Now put h equal to 0. If you put h is equal to 0, cos 2x by 2, that is equal to cos x.
Completed, sir.
Very good. Now write one more formula, last two formulas. Let me explain. Don't write now. Let me explain. Sir, u, v are two functions. I am asking you to differentiate it. Whenever you are differentiate it, how to differentiate it? U, v are the two persons. I want to differentiate it. First, keep this u aside and differentiate this. Plus, keep this differentiated. Keep this b aside and differentiate it. Repeating you. Whenever you are differentiating, na, the formula is u into d by dx of v plus v into d by dx of u. U v na, keep u aside, differentiate v, plus keep v aside, differentiate u. That's the thing. Keep u aside, differentiate v, and keep v aside and differentiate u. That is called u v rule. Okay, another thing, see, d by dx of u by v means if y is there, means let me give an example here. U v rule. U into dv by dx plus v into du by dx. How to do it, master? One example I'm saying, see. D by dx of x square into sine x, I asked. And if in between plus is there, means x square derivative 2x, sine x derivative cos x. Like that we'll do. In between plus is there, we can do the derivative like that. But if in between minus is into is there, then how to differentiate it, na? Keep x square aside. D by dx of sine x. Keep sine x aside. D by dx of x square. Sine x derivative is cos x. Yes, sine x is aside. X square derivative is 2x. That is how we'll use UV rule. U into V. Keep U aside, V derivative. Keep V aside, U derivative. Copy. Right, the next one. Next, u by v rule. Before last formula. Before we are going to start the objectives, last formula. U by v rule, we have to say. That is d by dx of u by v is equal to, first we have to write v square. V into du by dx minus u into dv by dx. The example can d by dx of sine x by x square, suppose d by dx of sine x by x square, that this act as a u and this act as a v. First we have to write v square, matlab x square whole square, x square into sine x derivative cos x. And x square derivative is 2x. So x square cos x minus 2x sin x by x power 4. That's the thing. Copy it. Now be ready for the questions. If it's completed, please inform me.
Yes.
Okay.
Sir, chain rule.
Chain rule next. When we start the questions, we'll start chain rule. Chain rule don't have any special formula. Completed. Yeah, now look at one after another questions well solved. Okay, first question. D by dx of x cube sin x e power x 6. So look at, while we are doing this differentiation, one property called linearity property. What is this linearity property, you know? Sir, if 3 into x plus y is there, shall I multiply this 3 like this? Is it correct or wrong? I can write it like this, no?
Yes, sir.
I can write it like this. I can distribute that 3 to. If I'm like this, x plus y whole cube, is it correct now?
No, sir.
It is wrong. It is correct. So, every time you can't distribute. If you have 2 chocolates, you can distribute to your friends. If you have 2 ice, you can't distribute. What we can distribute, the property is called linearity property. Like, derivative also satisfies the linearity property. It can be written as d by dx of x cube, d by dx of sin x, d by dx of e power x, d by dx of 6, x cube derivative 3x square, sin x derivative cos x, e power x derivative e power x, 6 derivative constant as 0. That is 3x square plus cos x plus e power x. In the same way, d by dx of x plus 2 whole square is there. So before we are differentiating, first expand a plus b whole square formula. X square plus 4x plus 4. Again, using linearity property plus d by dx of 4. This derivative of 1, it's a 0. That's a 2x plus 4. Okay. Now, I'm writing, after copying this, I'm writing three questions, solid, fast, easy questions. D by dx of sine x plus 5x cube plus 6 root x plus tan x plus 5. D by dx of x plus 3 whole, x plus 2 whole cube. Please do those derivatives. First copy that and do the derivatives. Within a minute, I'll be back. Please do it. What is the answer for first one? Anyone doing? Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Do it first. make it fast, please. So much thing we have to study. And remember one point, everyone stop writing. It's the first class on differentiation. No? If you understand it, then only plus one, plus two, engineering, or if you study science, everywhere the differentiation will be there. If you are not understanding, means remember your every future will be a question mark. That's why. If you are not understanding, same, I'll repeat it again.
Sir, second number answer.
Konsa wala?
Sir, question number two.
One ho gaya na? Dekho question number two, Baba. X plus two whole square na? Ye to a plus b whole square ka formula kya? X square plus 4x plus 4.
Yes, sir.
Now bar dy by dx hai na, distribute karo. Teen terms hai, three terms ka distribute karo. D by dx of x square, 4 into like that, it will come. So 2x plus 4. Simple single derivatives. Complete it. Please fast. Anamika, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Completed, Anamika.
Yes, sir. Second one answer, I'm not sure, but third one done.
Oh, second one means this second one. Eh?
Sir, question number two that you have given.
Sir, I have solved.
I'll do it, sir. Do by dx of na. A plus b whole cube ka formula kya hai? A cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square plus, that's a formula. Now d by dx of x cube plus 3 into x square into 2, 3 into x into 2 square plus 2 cube. D by dx of a 3x square, 3x cube, 6x square plus 4, 3 is 12x plus 8. Now differentiate it, distribute it. Property kya? Property naam kya? Idhar ek hi property bola na, ye property ka naam kya hai? Linearity means you can distribute. Now differentiate. X cube derivative 3x square. X square derivative 2x. A x hai na. Iska derivative 1 hai. Constant ka derivative 0 hai. Agar equal to aaya. So 9x square plus 12x plus 12. A formula. 9x square plus 12x plus 12. It.
Sir.
Ah.
So in the second step, have you written 3x cube?
Oh, x cube only. What 3x cube? X cube. 3x cube. X cube only, Bob. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Yes. Next question is, again, three questions I'll give. Try it. Few minutes I'll give. Again, I'll teach. Question number one. Yeah, do it. Nothing wrong. I'm right. I'm asking you to write the formulas indirectly. Now do it, please.
So first one is 20x plus 6 plus cos x.
Okay.
So second one, 3 plus x square x.
3 plus secant square x. Third one, other boys, please respond. So these are not very big problems. Before you are finding derivative, you have to expand this first. 9x square plus sin x. 10x square plus 6x plus 1 plus sin x. 20x in x square derivative 2x. X derivative 1, constant derivative 0, cos x derivative sin x. And here it is direct formula. X derivative is 1, tan x derivative is secant square x. Do it now. Expand the formulas. Completed log x derivative 1 by x. There log x derivative is 1 by x. Sin inverse x derivative 1 by root over 1 minus x square. Tan inverse x derivative 1 by 1 plus x square. Root x derivative 1 by 2 root x. Root x derivative is 1 by 2 root x. You should be very much clear with the formulas, Baba. If you are not able to read the formulas well, everything will be collapsed. That's why I'm requesting, please read the formulas perfectly. Yeah, the next question. So before going to the next question, please, I'll write some formulas right now. First one, trigonometry. Formulas belongs to trigonometry and we'll use in differentiation. First one, sine 2 theta is equal to 2 sine theta cos theta. Write the formulas there where we'll use in here. Cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus 2 sine square theta or 2 cos square theta minus 1. Cos 2 theta equal to 1 minus 2 sine square theta or 2 cos square theta minus 1. 2 tan theta by 1 minus tan square theta. This never will use. No need of this. Two sine a cos b, two cos a cos b, minus two sine a sine b. Two sine a cos b formula is sine a plus b plus sine a minus b. Two cos a cos b, cos a plus b plus cos a minus b. Cos a plus b minus cos a minus b. Now we'll use these formulas in the derivatives. Please note that. That will also help us. That will also help us.
Sir, completed.